floor?
The roof.
Where to?
Down. Should we call someone?
Cover your ears.
Health and safety department, what seems to be the problem?
Yeah, there's been electric short circuit. The elevator isn't moving.
Well, unfortunately, all units are occupied right now, but I can dispatch one to you as soon as possible.
When is as soon as possible?
I can't say for sure. It'll be anywhere between 10 minutes and a number of hours.
All right, well, thanks anyway. Have a nice day.
Well, that was specific.
Guess that's why you pay taxes. Damn it.
You in a hurry?
I guess you could say that.
Where are you off to?
Class, I have to present.
Present what?
My paper. It's a Keynesian take on the current economic downturn.
Don't worry, I'm sure you can present a different time.
So, I take it you're a university student?
Yeah.
What do you study?
International business.
Sounds interesting.
No.
So, anyone know any games?
What about you? What do you study?
No, I don't.
Did you graduate?
No, I never went.
So what do you do?
I'm a sanitation engineer.
Sanitation engineer?
It's the government's latest non-discriminatory term for what I do.
So, what do you do?
I'm a garbage man.
Oh!
Don't feel bad for me, I'm happy with what I do.
And you're content?
No, I'm actually happy.
How?
What do you mean, how?
Well, I just don't see how you can be happy doing what you do.
So what, garbage men can't be happy?
That's not what I'm saying.
It's just that, wouldn't you be happier with a good job?
Define a good job.
Well, a job that enables you to earn more money and makes your life more comfortable.
Nah, a good job is one that makes you happy.
But how can you be happy doing what you do?
I have purpose.
What do you mean?
Every night I go out and do my job, I'm actively benefiting society. You may not always notice my presence, but you sure as hell notice my absence.
What about the future then? I mean, I have a hard time imagining your job taking you far.
And you're saying that an education is what I need to change that?
Yes, at least that's my opinion.
Well, what do you do?
I study literature mostly, but other things too. I just feel that there's so much knowledge that I need to take in, and so little time to do it.
I can respect that, but how exactly do you have more of a future than I do?
I just believe that education opens more doors. It gives you more possibilities.
Possibilities for what?
To do something that matters. To have the opportunity to be a part of something bigger and have an impact on the world around us.
I agree.
But then why are you studying business?
I don't know. To contribute to society on a larger scale.
But how?
If I do my job well, I'll be able to stimulate the economy and bring our country forward.
So that's your life's ambition? To stimulate the economy?
Well, not just that. I'll be able to ensure a comfortable life for myself in the process.
But why do you need an expensive college degree for that?
Simple. Statistically, college graduates earn more money.
I just can't justify spending that much time and money simply learning how to make it back just so I can eventually live in a big house, drive a nice car, and watch the news on a giant TV.
Well, we only live once, but wouldn't you want to live as comfortably as possible?
That doesn't really help anyone but yourself, though.
Although it is a noble goal to help others, I just can't think of many people who have dedicated their lives to the idea, maybe short of Gandhi and Mother Teresa. We all have dreams, and I figure it's our duty in life to try and reach for them. My dream is to be a successful businessman and to be in the cover of magazines. I feel that if I accomplish that, I can die knowing that I achieved something. Hell, if I die now, there be no more than some pictures, transcripts, and yearbooks to prove that I even existed. And yes, this goal is inherently selfish, but I think that we should really learn to accept that we are selfish creatures, and that altruism is a virtue that not many truly possess.
You do have a point there. If I die now, there won't be much to remember me by either. I mean, I'm not afraid of dying now. I'm afraid of losing my potential. It's a lot like the ancient Greeks. I've been reading about them lately. They have this idea that when you die, they don't mourn the loss of life. They mourn the loss of potential. The Greeks thought of what could have been, not what has been. I'm sure that when you were a kid, you didn't really dream of becoming a garbage man. I mean, I know you're happy doing what you do now, but didn't you have any aspirations of being great? Of being remembered?
Yeah, well, sadly, the thing with dreams is they're unrealistic. We can't all grow up to be astronauts, race car drivers, and CEOs. Some of us need to sacrifice to pave the road for those few who will actually accomplish it. I mean, yeah, I may not be fulfilling my potential, but if I followed my dreams, somebody else would have to give up theirs to take my place.
This is also true. So what about you? What do you think about all of this? You've been awfully quiet.
I don't know. I've never really given it much thought.
See, I can understand the idea of going to college in order to secure a safe and comfortable lifestyle for yourself, but I can't wrap my head around the idea of why you'd spend so much money on an education with the sole intention of acquiring knowledge.
But without a means to acquire knowledge, life would be meaningless.
So why do you need an expensive education for that? Look, I have a library card, and to date, there hasn't been a single book that I went looking for that I couldn't find.
College is not just about the books, though. It's about all the expertise the professors bring.
But why would you pay for that knowledge? There's so much more out there for free. For example, you know the little creek around the corner? There's this guy there, Norm. He spends all day, every day, just fishing. He's a retired trucker and he's probably the wisest guy I've ever met. I get that we as humans are supposed to grow as intellectuals and gather knowledge. I get that we're supposed to study poetry and literature, but the way I see it, all that knowledge is already recorded somewhere. But the knowledge a guy like Norm acquires throughout his life will be completely lost and it dies with him if nobody ever bothers to stop and listen. Every day before I go to work, I sit with him, and he tells me the second half of the day before's story and the first half of the next. I guess that's how he keeps me coming. The point is, if growing old is only about being able to tell stories like the ones he has, I'll embrace old age with open arms.
But if you want to tell stories like that, why do you work as a garbage man?
I'm not always going to be a garbage man. There's plenty of things I can do. My job doesn't define who I am, it merely provides for me. I'm going to do a lot of things in my life, but I won't be able to be a garbage man when I'm old, so might as well get that out of the way now. I want to be the next Norm. I want to tell fascinating stories about my youth and the things I've discovered. And I don't need to be famous or admired by many, but unlike the two of you, and well, maybe you, although I don't know what you want to do, I have no idea where I'm going to be in 5 years, and I really cherish that thought. Yeah, I know, it sounds cheesy, but if there was only one goal I had in my life, it would be to inspire somebody the same way that Norm inspired me.
That's a nice sentiment.
Thanks.
Wow, that was surprisingly fast. That would be stuck here for hours.
Yeah, well, I guess that's why we pay taxes.
Well, it was nice meeting you guys.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah.